First Kings chapter 19.
我们今天要来看列王记上第十九章。
Now Ahab, the king of Israel at the time, he told his wife Jezebel everything Elijah, who was a prophet, had done, and how he had killed all the prophets. That's the prophets of Baal, not like the other prophets of God. All the prophets of Baal with the sword. So Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah and say, "May the gods deal with me, be it ever so severely, if by this time tomorrow I do not make your life like one of them." Now Elijah, he was afraid and he ran for his life. But when he came to Beersheba in Judah, he left his servant there while he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness. Now he came to a broom bush, sat down under it and prayed that he might die. "I have had enough. I have had enough, Lord. Take my life. I am no better than my ancestors."
列王记上十九章第一节，以色列当时的王亚哈把以利亚所做的一切事，以及他怎样杀掉所有巴利先知的经过，都告诉了耶洗别，就是他的太太。耶洗别就派人去告诉以利亚说，明天这个时候，我若不使你像那些人一样丧命，愿神明重重的惩罚我。以利亚很害怕，连忙逃命，来到犹大的别示巴，他让仆人留在那里，自己在旷野走了一天的路程，来到一棵罗藤树下，坐下来祷告求死，说，耶和华，我受够了，求你取走我的性命吧，我不比我的祖先强。
feel like there's someone here today,
我感觉我们当中有些人
who feel like you don't have the strength to keep going,
你觉得自己好像没有力量再走下去了。
And that's what I want to speak to you today about.
这就是今天我想来跟你分享。
When there is nothing left in me,
我没有办法走下去了。
Why don't we pray?
我们一起来祷告。
Father God, we thank you.
父神，我们感谢你。
For today,
感谢你今天。
I thank you for every person who's present in this room and watching online.
感谢今天你让每一个来到我们当中或在线上收看的人。
I know in their lives right now,
我知道在他们的生命中
there is a tension,
好像有一股张力。
That they know the hope that you gave them, and yet they feel the hopelessness that's deep in their hearts.
他们知道你有赐给他们那一份盼望，可是也不知道为什么心里面就是感觉到无比绝望。
To those people, God,
主啊，就是这些人。
Today you're going to do a mighty work.
我求你今天来做成的大工。
There are some people here today, Lord.
我们当中有一些人
who don't know how to keep going.
他们真的是不知道怎么再走下去了。
But to those people, I know you're going to do a mighty work.
我知道这些人你能够做成大功。
In fact, God,
主啊，事实上，
every single person standing and watching online right now,
每一个现场站立在这里或者是在线上观看的人，
from the front to the back,
从前到后，
you're going to do a mighty work.
我相信你都要在他们的生命里面做成大功。
Because your presence,It's here right now.
因为你的同在此刻就在我们当中。
So come and do what only you can do.
主啊，愿你来做成唯有你能做的事。
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣基督的名求。
All God's people said.
神的百姓都说。
Amen.
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 Since it's Resurrection Sunday.
今天既然是复活节主日。
And our title is called Rise Again.
我们叫做 Rise Again.
We're going to ask you to keep standing for the rest of the service.
我们今天就是特别一点，就直接站到底了，好不好？
Jesus can go to the cross for you.
就是你别忘了，你只是站着，耶稣为你上的是十字架。
I'm just kidding. Please come.
开玩笑，开玩笑，大家请坐。
I watch a lot of movies.
你知道我很常看电影。
I do. If I don't like movies so much and give more time to prayer, maybe you know the church will be in better shape. But I love watching movies.
真的，我看很多电影。如果我有把我看电影的时间花一半去祷告，可能教会会更好。
I do have to admit, I do think I pray. I mean, I watch movies more than I pray.
牧师承认就是对我真的就是看可能看电影看的比较多。
Now I love watching movies because I like watching how a director tells a story.
我之所以喜欢看电影，所以我很喜欢看导演怎么样去让一个故事被呈现出来。
But whichever movie you watch,
可是我告诉你，不论你看什么哪一部电影
，the story kind of follows an arc.A story arc.
就是基本上故事是有一个起承转合的。
And whatever movie you watch, there always come a part, a point in the movie when all the best thing, the best part of the story has already happened.
你不论是看哪一种的电影呢，那个电影一定都会有演到一个高峰，然后就觉得啊，差不多了，这个剧情已经大概你都知道后面会发生什么事。
And everything is just winding down.
因为已经最棒的情节都已经发生完，然后就等着它什么时候结束。
Like Liam Neeson has saved his daughter.Again,
就好像《极客救援》里面，连恩尼逊他又救了一次他女儿。
Or the guy has already ran to the airport, and the girl says, "Yes, I will stay."
或者是你知道，就是他冲到机场，然后跟他求婚，他说：“啊，我留下来。”这种剧情。
And so, at that point in the movie, you know the best part of the story has passed.
通常演到那一刻的时候，你就知道说啊，这个电影最好的情节已经演到差不
多了。And everything else is just winding down.
剩下就是等着他要看他怎么收尾。
You're not biting your nails anymore, wondering what's going to happen.
你知道等到那个最后收尾的时候，你不会一直咬着指甲说啊，接下来不知道会怎么样。
And you might even take out your phone just to check your messages.
你可能已经手机就拿出来，然后开始在看有没有简讯进来。
Because after all, the best part is over.
因为反正演到那里，电影的最高潮都演完了，不是吗
？The best part is over.
最高潮、最好看的地方都没了。
And I can't help but to wonder.
我忍不住在想
Is there somebody here today?
我不知道我们当中有没有人
Who believe that your best days are over?
你也觉得自己生命里面最高峰的时刻已经都过去了
That the best days of your life is behind you.
你觉得自己人生最精华、最好的日子已经过了
Now this really is a question of hope, right?
我告诉你，其实我在问这个问题，在问的是你有没有盼望
Because when we say I'm hopeful for the future.We're not saying I don't believe there are challenges in the future that I need to face.
我们不是说我相信这个未来我都不会有挑战，我不会有困难。
When we say I'm hopeful for the future, we're not saying I believe it's all smooth sailing from now on.
当我说我相信未来是有盼望的时候，我也不是表示说我未来一定一帆风顺。
When we say we have hope for the future, we're simply saying I believe the best days of my life are still ahead of me.
当我说我对未来有盼望的时候，是我相信我更棒的日子还在前头等着我。
And the best has yet to come.
那个最好最棒的时光还真要开始而已。
And so I wonder when we look in our lives today.
所以我不知道今天你回看你的人生。
When you look in your life today,
你看着你自己的生命。
Do you believe that the best is yet to come?
你相信最好的日子还正要开始吗
？For your health.
可能你的健康。
For your body.
你的身体。
For your walk with God.
可能你跟神同行的日子。
You know, it's always interesting to talk to people who are on fire for Jesus when they were in college.
你知道，就是跟那些还在大学里面人都说，哦，我为主火热，跟他们聊天真的很开心。
And a lot of time you talk to people in the 30s, they think back to the days when they were on fire for Jesus when they were still students.
然后可能你跟那些小社青，大概30岁出头的，然后就会讲说，哦，对我学生时代为主多么的火热。
But I may get a goal in my life that I will never look back to my college days and think those were the best days of serving Jesus.
可是我已经下定了决心，当我回头看的时候，我不要说我在大学的时候才是我服侍神最火热的时候。
No, this is my best day yet.
我告诉你，我现在才是最火热在服侍神。
And I want to be on fire for Jesus when I'm 50, when I'm 60, when I'm 70.
而且我只会越来越火热下去。我到50岁、60岁，我都会继续火热。
What about 80s, Peter?
那八十岁还可以吗
？I'll see if I live that long. I don't know.
我不知道能不能活到那个时候，但是活到老服侍到老。
Doesn't matter. But I do believe the best is yet to come.
我相信最好的日子才正要开始。
But if you don't.
可是如果你不这么认为呢？
It's okay.
我告诉你也没有关系。
You came to the right place.
因为你今天就这样表示你来对地方了。
Because I bet you you're not the only one who thinks that right now.
如果你觉得最好日子已经都过了，我告诉你，你绝对不是唯一的一个。
That there's somebody, at least somebody, sitting in your row, to your left and to your right, who is just as hopeless as you feel right now.
我可以跟你保证，你同排的人，可能现在有人已经在左右张望，那个就是可能跟你一样，有着觉得自己最好的人生已经都过去的人。
And this brings us to the story of Elijah.
这就是让我们看回来以利亚的故事。
Now Elijah was a man who was on fire for Jesus.
以利亚真的是一个为主、为耶和华火热的人。
They call him the fiery prophet.
他们基本上称他为说是火的先知。
And he was on fire for God.
对，你要知道他为耶和华火热。
And at one time he was fed up with the double-mindedness of the Israelites.
有一次他就觉得这个以色列人就是服侍神的时候二心，他受不了了。
He was fed up with the fact that they would worship Baal and they would worship Yahweh at the same time.
就觉得说这群人怎么可以这样，又拜耶和华，然后又拜巴利。
So he called for a showdown between the prophets of Baal and him.
所以他就说，好好，你们现在巴利的先知，通给我站出来。
There were 450 of them.
然后我们基本上就来个对抗，然后对方是450人，他只有他一个人。他们说，我们来祷告。
Let's have a matchup. Let's see whose God is going to send down fire from heaven.
我们现在来比赛，我们就两方各方祷告，然后看谁的神会让火降下来。
And in case you're not familiar with the story, Elijah won.
那你可能不知道这个故事，但没关系，我告诉你结果，以利亚他赢了。
Fire came down.
我们就直接爆雷，就火就降下来。
But here's the thing.
可是我告诉你。
Here's the thing. I know you're impressed when fire come down.
你可能会觉得说，哇，好厉害，火这样降下来。
I would be impressed.
是我也会惊讶。
But the king of Israel was not.
可是以色列的王却没有。
Ahab.
亚哈王。
And his wife.
跟他的太太。
So the Bible says in verse 1 that we just read that Ahab told Jezebel everything that Elijah had done.
就是我们刚读到的第一节，亚哈把以利亚所做的一切及他怎样杀掉所有巴利先知都告诉耶洗别。
He told her everything that he had done.
亚哈王告诉耶洗别所有一切以利亚做的事。
Maybe they were having dinner one day.
他们可能在吃着晚餐。
Hey babe, hey honey.
哎，老婆。
Did you hear about what happened?
有没有听说今天发生什么事
？To the prophets of Baal.
就是那些巴利先知，你知道
？We need to dig 450 graves.
我今天就一次死了450个人，所以我们要挖450个人的墓。
And Jezebel went, wait, what? What did you say?
耶洗别说，哈，你讲啥
？And then. 我们怎么变得是那种名士的一个剧了？
配合剧情，
三立台。In case you're not from Taiwan， 三立台是三立台。Okay， I don't know how to explain。我不知道怎么解释，我不知道怎么解释。I don't know how to explain to you。And that became a problem。
那突然就成了一个问题。
It became a problem for Elijah。
变成是耶利亚哈。
I know when we look at the story, it seems like Elijah's problem was that Ahab told Jezebel everything that that Elijah had done.
我们看起来好像，哎，刚刚其实发生的事就是亚哈把以利亚所做的事情告诉耶洗别。
So we think that's the problem.
我们就觉得说，哎，好像这是个问题。
But what if I tell you?
可是如果我告诉你
，the biggest problem for Elijah.
其实对以利亚说，他面对到最大的问题
was not that.Ahab told Jezebel everything he had done.
不是亚哈把他自己做的事情通通告诉耶洗别。
It's the fact that Elijah believed that's all he could ever do.
而是他相信他以为自己杀光的那些巴利先知是唯一他能做的，他以后就不能再做些别的，那才是他的问题。
He thought that was all that was within him.
他以为他自己尽到最大的能耐，能够做成事情都做完了。
And this is why he was so drained.
这是为什么他会觉得自己好枯干。
He was so drained.
他觉得自己枯干到。
Not because of the showdown.
其实不是因为他们之间的这些竞争。
But because the showdown did not show the result that he was looking for.
而是当他这样竞争完了以后，没有达到他期待的结果。
He thought to himself, what else do you want from me?
他想说我还能做什么其他的
？Ahab,
亚哈
，Israelites.
就是这些以色列人。
Fire came down.
我都已经让火这样降下来。
Moses didn't even do that.
连摩西都做不到这么大的神迹。
What else do you want from me?
我还能做什么
？What else can I do?
我还能做什么别的
？He thought to himself.
他就想。
That was my best try.
我已经尽了我最大的能耐了。
But it was still not enough.
可是却发现还是做不到。
What happens when you give your best try and it's not enough?
如果你觉得我都已经尽力了，可是还是做不到，怎么办？
What happens when you have issues in your relationships?
可能你跟另外一半之间的关系发生一些问题。
And you went to counseling.
然后你一起上咨商。
Brought all the books.
然后你买了所有婚姻辅导的书。
And you 砍断所有的魂，过去的魂结。
And you
did everything.
Soul ties and everything.
You wake up and you do devotion in the morning together, but you end up fighting with each other. You do everything.
你早上起来就马上灵修祷告，可是你们两个当天还是一直吵架，你该怎么办好？
And nothing changes.
你就发现你做了一切事情都还是没用。
That kills your hope for the future.
那基本上会让你对未来就没了盼望，不是吗？
Now I heard many people say Elijah, he probably was depressed. That's why he wanted to die.
你知道我听过很多人就说啊，以利亚可能患有这个忧郁症，所以他会求死。
Now I don't know because none of them were actually psychologists who had an interview with. Elijah.
我也不知道，因为讲这些话的人，他其实也没有跟以利亚谈过嘛，对不对？
Yeah. So maybe Elijah had depression, maybe he didn't. I don't know.
所以可能他有忧郁症吧，也可能他没有啊，我也不晓得。
But it's easy for us to just label the condition that might be in Elijah instead of paying attention to the condition that Elijah was in.
可是我们很常就会先把他贴一个标签说啊，他就是有忧郁症，所以他才会那样，而是没有去看说，那他到底是在一个什么样的状态里面，让他产生了这样子的情况。
Sometimes we pay so much more attention to this label of a condition rather than paying attention to the condition that we are in.
有时候我们只是太一直关注的说啊，他有这样的问题，他有那样的问题，却没有去关注那到底那个问题是什么。
Is it possible?
有没有可能
that he didn't have depression? I don't know.
我真的要说，我真的不知道他到底有没有忧郁症。没有的话呢？
Is it possible that maybe he's just disappointed?
有没有可能他真的不是有忧郁症，他只是太失望了？
Because sometimes disappointment can cut.Just as deep in your heart as depression.
因为你要知道，失望有时候失望透顶，也会像忧郁症那样子的，让你心里面淌血。
When your hope is deterred, when your hope is dashed, it kills something inside of us.
当你觉得你的盼望完全都被毁掉了，然后你的里面其实会在你的心里面产生好像一个很大的空缺。
And it changes the way you look at things. It changes the way you look at life.
那会使你开始改变你看事情、看人生的眼光。
Verse 3 says Elijah was afraid and he ran for his life.
第三节我们看到说以利亚很害怕，连忙逃命。
Except the word afraid is not actually in the Hebrew original language in this passage.
那你要知道这一句经文在原本希伯来。
It doesn't say the word afraid.
他没有讲到害怕这个字。
The word that appears, the verb that appears, is not afraid but saw.
当时在希伯来文原文不是说害怕，是说他看见。
So it actually reads, Elijah saw, and then he ran for his life.
所以原文是什么？以利亚他看见，因此连忙逃命。
The problem was what he was watching.
重点是他到底在看的是什么
？See Elijah, he used.To see opportunities in every opposition.
以利亚以前是一个怎么样的人？凡是要来抵挡他的，他总是看到里面哪里有机会。
400 prophets of Baal.
哦，四百五十个巴利先知，是不是？太棒了。
That's going to be 450 witnesses to what God can do.
那我们就是要在这450个人当中，让他们看见神能够做什么。
He used to see the opportunities.
以前他总是看到都是机会。
But now Elijah can only see the opposition.And the opportunities.
可是他现在，即便机会都已经在他眼前，他只看到人们要怎么来抵挡他。
Because that's what disappointment does.
失望就是会这样改变一个人的眼光。
It changes the way you look at something.
它让你完全改变你看事情的眼光。
And I wonder what has happened in your past.
我不知道你的过去经历到了些什么。
That have slowly over time changed the way you look at life.
让你一步一步的也开始改变了你看你自己人生的眼光。
What hopes did you once have?
你过去你还记得你曾经抱有什么样子的盼望吗
？And what disappointments did you experience?
那你又因着那当时的那个期望，然后你好像经历到了什么失望
？That limit what you are able to see.
让你现在你会发现你的眼光好像变得很狭隘。
So Elijah, he became afraid.
以利亚他变得他害怕了
，and he started to run for his life.
就开始逃命了。
Now Elijah was He wasn't a stranger to running. He's used to running.
以利亚，这不是他第一次逃命哦，他以前也逃过。
不是逃命，他
逃跑跑。
那不是要跑。
跑，他跑。
Because there's a difference.
这两者是有差的。
And you're going to see.
我们来看看差别在哪。
He was not a stranger to running.
他对于跑这件事情他不陌生。
Because even one chapter back.
因为我们就在看前一章。
In chapter 18.
第十八章的时候。
It says Elijah he ran from Mount Carmel to Jezreel.
他讲到说，以利亚他从加密山跑到
Jezreel.
耶斯列。
He ran from Mount Carmel to Jezreel.
他从加密山跑到耶斯列。
Now, just to let you know, that's not the distance from 忠孝复兴 to 忠孝敦化。
你要知道，这个距离不是很短哦。
It's not even on the same city.
他甚至不是在同一个城市里面跑而已。
In fact, if you look at the geography, that's 50 kilometers.
如果你有看地理上面地图的话，这个距离是五十公里耶。
50 kilometers.
五十公里的距离。
Marathon is 42 kilometers.
而且你知道，不是只是四十二哦。
马拉松是
就已经四十二了。
Marathon is 42.
马拉松就已经跑四十二公里了。
This dude. Sorry, Elijah. I know you're one. This guy.
你知道这家伙。
He ran longer than a marathon runner.
他跑得比马拉松的跑者还远呢。
I mean, I'm tired just running 2 kilometers.
我这个光跑两 K 就已经累半死。
I'm tired just sitting at home watching TV, seeing somebody run the marathon.
我光是看电视上面有人在跑马拉松，我就觉得哦，好累哦。
But this guy, he ran for 50 kilometers.
但这个人
he knows how to run.
他跑了是整整五十公里，可见他很会跑啊。
He knows how to run. In fact, he was a runner.
他是一个很会跑的人。
He knew how to run after the heart of God.
他知道怎么样追随着神的心而跑。
Because his heart was dedicated to him.
因为他完全是全心归向主。
There was nobody who was as on fire as Elijah. He was single-minded in his heart in serving God.
你可以说当时没有一个人像他一样这么热心服侍耶和华，只有他是这样全心的向着他。
He had a single focus to bring revival.To the land.
他基本上是全心的渴望看见复兴临到这地。
And he knew how to run the good race.
他知道怎么样跑那当跑的路。
And for his life, for as long as he can remember, he was running towards the calling that God has for him.
所以对他来说，你可以说活到那个时候的他，他基本上很知道怎么样照着神对他的呼召，他全心的向前奔跑。
But that was chapter 18.
但是那是在第十八章里面的以利亚。
And now we're in 19.
我们刚刚读到的是第十九章。
And something can change just like that.
翻一页，然后就发现故事都改变了。
Because a chapter later, Elijah he's still running.
我们在第十九章，也就是一章后，发现他还继续在跑。
But this time he's running away.
可是这一次不是向着主跑，而是在逃命了。
Can I just ask you a question?
我可不可以再问各位一个问题？
What defines your life right now?
现在到底是什么在定义你的人生？
Are you running away from something or are you running towards something?
你的人生是在逃跑某一些的东西，还是你知道你的人生是朝着某一个目标在跑？
We all run.
我们都在跑啊，大家。
Yeah, I gotta run.
我们每个人其实不知不觉都在跑。
Nobody's sitting still.
没有人就是一直站在原位的。
You're either running towards something or you're running away from something.
只是你的跑是有定向，还是你在逃往某一些？逃跑。
Now I'm not judging you if you're running away from something.
如果你是逃跑，我告诉你，我也没有要论断你的意思。
And I'm not going to ask you to raise your hand and admit.
现在我也没有要你举手说，哦，对，我就是一个在逃跑的人。
But if your whole life is being defined by running away from something.
可是如果你的人生一直都在逃离一些你不想要面对的事。
I want to ask you something.
那我要问你了。
I'm not judging you.
我你要知道，我不是在论断你。
I just want to ask.
可是我只是要问。
Don't you know that the promises of the days ahead of you are far greater than the mistakes and the shames of the days behind you?
你难道不知道神所给你的应许远大过于那些你渴望逃离的问题？你难道不知道吗？
So stop running away.
不要再逃了。
I can't help but to wonder what you're going to miss.If you spend your whole life running away from your past,
如果你的一生都因为害怕去面对你的过去而不断在逃跑，我真的不知道你错过了多少美好的事。
When you're running away from what you are afraid of, when you're running away from what you are ashamed of.
当你一直在逃跑，好像你想要跑离你过去的悔恨，跑离你过去的羞愧。
Because if you spend your whole focus running away from the past, you're going to have no energy and no focus to run towards what God has for you.
因为那是你全心，你好像醒来，你只能想到过去的悔恨，我不想看过去的羞愧，我也不想面对，所以我只能逃跑。可是当你把你的精力都用在这事情上的时候，你没有办法看神要给你的东西。
So Elijah, he was afraid. He ran for his life.
以利亚他害怕，我们刚读到第三节，他太害怕就逃跑。
And he came to Beersheba in Judah, and he left his servant there, while he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness.
他来到犹大别示巴，他让仆人留在那里，自己在旷野走了一天的路程。
Now that's a pretty long journey, a day's journey.
我们刚刚讲了，这一趟又是很远，跑了一天呐。
It's not the same thing as 忠孝复兴。忠孝东路四段至忠孝东路五段 okay, that's not the distance.
这个距离其实没有那么的短哦。
It's more like 桃园to 台北。
就是基本上已经可以跑到
桃园。Day's journey.
他跑了一天的路。
Now he left his servant behind.
然后我们看到他让他的仆人留在原地。
Because he didn't want anyone around him.
我告诉你，因为他真的不希望有任何人住在他身边。
He didn't want anyone near him.
他不想要任何人靠近他，想要自己一个人。
That reminds him of the word serve.
他不想要有任何的人事物，让他看到了会想到服侍这件事。
He wasn't trying to leave his servant behind. He's trying to leave his serving days behind.
其实他不是只是想让仆人留在原地，他是想要让自己服侍的那些过去的日子都不要再去想。
Because watching his faithful servant is a reminder to what he's abandoning right now.
因为他看到那个忠心的仆人，他就会想到自己过去是多么火热服侍神，但我现在都要放下。你可能会觉得这好好笑。
But are there times in your life?
可是我不知道你有没有发生过这样。
You're so disappointed in God.
你真的觉得对神太失望。
That you decided, you know what? Whatever, I'm just gonna go wild. I'm gonna go out and have a wild party.
你就想说，我不要再守那些什么诫命，我现在就是要出去做个狂野，我要放浪。
And then before you go out,
那你出去之前
，you take off your cross.
你就把十字架项链先拿下来。
And your hope bracelet.
就是原本戴的那个 hope 的手环。
Because you don't want anything to remind you.
就放下。为什么
？Of what you're abandoning.
因为你看到就想到，哦，我以前在 hope 多么的火热。
That's how.Elijah fell.
我告诉你，那就是以利亚当时的心。
Now don't judge him because you probably did that in your life.
所以你不要论断他，因为可能你自己也做过类似这样的事。
But here's the thing.
但问题在哪
？And I hope you hear this because this is so important.
我希望你听懂这句，因为这个真的太重要了。
You can try to run away from your disappointments.
你可以尝试要逃离那些让你失望的事。
But that doesn't mean you're running towards your fulfillment.
可是只是因为你逃离了，却不代表你有朝着完成你命定前进。
You can try to run away from your past. You can try to run away from your hurt in the past.
你可以尝试从你的过去，或是你过去受的那些伤逃离。
Running, you're like running.
你想说我要逃离那些伤
，and you're running.
我不断在逃离。
But just because you're running away from something,
可是只因为你在逃离那些东西
，just because you're running away from your past hurt,
只因为你好像觉得你离过去的伤很远了
，doesn't mean you're running towards your healing.
可是却不代表你有朝着医治前进啊
！Don't confuse the two.
你要知道这两者是有差别的。
Some of you, you keep running from your heart, you're running from your hurt, and you wonder why is it that you're not healed? Because just because you're running from that doesn't mean you're running towards anything.
你不断的看着说，哦，我的伤，我好像离他很远了，我离他很远。可是你就说，我怎么也没有得到医治？因为你只是一直在看着你过去的伤，你没有在朝着医治前进。
So where did Elijah run to?
所以以利亚到底在朝着哪里跑
？He ran to this middle of nowhere, and he found this.Tree, this broom.
他跑到一个地方，然后到一个罗藤树下。
Verse four.
第四节。
He came to a broom. He sat down under it and prayed that he might die. He said to God, "I have had enough, Lord. Take my life. I'm no better than my ancestors."
以利亚他来到一棵罗藤树下，坐下来祷告求死，说：耶和华，我受够了，求你取走我的性命吧，我并不比我的祖先强。
Talk about being dramatic.
有没有比他还会演的
？He pick a perfect spot to die.
就是自己死还要死在一个他选到一个完美的地方。
He found a tree.
他就找到一棵树。
And he sat down.
然后就坐在那里。
He make himself comfortable.
然后坐得好好的，衣服也理好。
Now people confused because people think Elijah wants to kill himself.
你知道有些人就以为说以利亚想要自杀。
But that's not what the Bible says.
但不是，圣经不是这样讲的。
He's asking God.
他是坐下来以后说，主啊，让我死吧。
He's asking God to take his life.
他说求主来杀了他吧。
So he's like, so now there are very few instances in the Bible, even in the Old Testament, where God directly took somebody's life.
你知道，基本上连在旧约里面都很少有耶和华直接好像取了某个人的性命。
So for Elijah to pray that he's thinking, okay, maybe, like the sins of Korah, the land opened up and.They got swallowed. Do that to me, God.
所以以利亚他可能想着过去啊，可拉有过那个他们被地整个就是地打开了以后就被吞下去。他说可能们在发生这样。
Or Lot's wife.
或者是罗德太太。
Became a pillar of salt.
突然就变成岩柱了。
Do that.
主啊，再做一次吧。
Well, how about they just stick with the theme, right? Fire. Just send down fire right now and just burn me up.Burn me up, God.
既然我祷告你就降下火，那主今天你就燃烧我吧，燃烧尽了。继续等待。
Come on, God.
主啊，还不快点
！Burn me up.
主啊，烧光我。
我 open the ground.
或者是地打开。
Turn me into a pillar of salt.
吞下我或让我变岩柱。
Do something, God.
做点什么吧，神。
It actually took a lot of faith for him to pray that prayer.
你要知道，他要做这种祷告，是主直接这样取了他性命，这个信心要多大
？He had faith in the wrong thing.
他的信心之大，可是却放错了地方。
This guy doesn't know how to give up his faith. He's still a guy of faith. He's just using it in the wrong ways.
这个人的信心真的是大到一个他都不知道怎么样，没有信心，可是他用错了地方，相信一个很奇怪的事。
Let me ask you something.
我问你
，Have you been? Do you have a lot of faith in a lie?
你有没有相信一个谎言，相信到一个你极深无比的地步，就是你深信不疑
？In a lie.
但你信的是个谎言。
Have you been faithful to a lie?
你有没有信一个谎言，信到一个极致
？Because Elijah was faithful to a lie.
以利亚他就是这样相信谎言。
What was the lie that he was faithful to?
他相信的谎言是什么
？What was the lie that he believed in?
他深信不疑的谎言是什么
？He said to God.
他对神说
，Take my life.
说取了我的性命吧。
Because I'm no better than my ancestors.
因为我不觉得我比我的祖先强。
Because they're dead.
因为他们都死了。
My ancestors.
那些祖先们。
Have no more days ahead of them.
就是他们好像也没有在他们前面的日子好过了。
They're laying in the ground.
他们都已经躺在地里。
With no more future to be written.
对他们来说有什么未来可言
？And that's me.
如今我也不是像这样吗
？I know I'm still alive.
我知道我是还活着。
Just like my ancestors.
但基本上我就像我的祖先一样。
Probably try.
我可能他们也努力过。
But there they are right now.
但他们，你看他们现在躺在哪
？And that's how I feel.
主啊，今天我也是这样的感觉。
The lie that Elijah believed in was that he did not believe there is any more chapters, any more days of his life that can still be written.
你可以说以利亚他深信不疑的谎言，就是他认为未来没有什么好再述说的了，在他的生命里面。
And Elijah believed the lie.
以利亚他相信一个谎言。
That no matter how hard he tried,
是不论他多么的努力
，he cannot escape what happened to his ancestors.
也还是逃离不了像他祖先所面临到的命运。
Have you ever tried as hard as you can to not repeat the mistakes of your parents?
你有没有试过，好像你用尽一切努力，不要再犯你父母犯过的错
？Like I would never do that.
他说我不会像我的爸爸妈妈。
I would never be like my dad.
我不会像我爸爸一样。
I would never be like my mom.
我绝对不会跟我妈一样。
But you try and you try and you try and you find yourself repeating the same story that you tried to run away from.
可是你已经用尽了你最大能耐，却发现你还是逃不了那个过去如鬼打墙般缠着你的命运。
And you believe this lie.
因此你也就相信一个谎言。
I am no better.
看来我也没有好到哪嘛。
So he lay down under the broom.Under the bush, verse 5, and he fell asleep. And at once an angel touched him and said, Get up and eat.
第五节，他躺在树下睡着了，有位天使拍醒他说：“起来吃东西吧。”
Aren't you glad God? Aren't you glad God doesn't answer every dumb prayer you pray?
你有没有很庆幸神没有回应你每一个做的蠢的祷告？
Oh God, that guy is so cute, make him fall in love with me.
主啊，那个男生好帅，让他给我爱上我吧。
God's like, God, if you only know what I know about him.
就是如果你知道我知道关于这个男生的事，你大概就。
Aren't you glad God doesn't answer all our dumb prayers?
你有吗？庆幸还好，没有每一个你做蠢的祷告、愚蠢的祷告神的回应。
He's like, kill me, God, take me up.
一定要说主啊，求我的，取我的性命吧。
God's like, why don't you just go to sleep?
是，主是说你要不要先睡一下再说。
Just go to sleep.
你先睡吧。
Because you're going to get up.
因为等一下你要起来。
And he looked around, and there by his head was some bread.Bake over hard coals and a jar of water, probably 气泡水 because that's the way I like it. And he drank and he ate, and then he lay down again. Now the angel of the Lord came back a second time and said, "Oh, this is going to take a while." And he touched him and said, "Get up and eat, for the journey is too much for you." So he got up and ate and drank, strengthened by the food. He traveled 40 days and 40 nights. Oh, this guy can still run.Until he reached Horeb, the mountain of God.
第六节，他睁开眼睛，见头边有用炭火烤好的饼和一瓶水。他吃喝完毕，又躺下来。耶和华天使第二次来拍醒他，说：“起来吃东西吧，你还要走很远的路。”以利亚起来吃喝，就有了力气，走了40昼夜，来到上帝的山和烈山。
Sometimes, excuse me.
Bless you.
Sometimes, how do you recover from that? Right? It's sometimes God is brutally honest.
有的时候神讲话真的是
没
有对，没有在含糊的。
Excuse me. Oh, ooh. I am allergic to the lies that some of you are believing right now.
你们有一些人深信不疑的谎言，实在是让我太过敏了。
Some of you right now.
所以我已经感觉到有些人那个谎言还在深深的扎根在你心里。我现在要赶走那些谎言。
Something in the air.
空气中弥漫着谎言的味道。
Now, God said to Elijah, he was honest, right?
你知道神对这里对以利亚说话，他非常的直接。
The journey ahead is too much for you.
也没有在乱盖，他说你还要走很远的路。
Well, thank you, God.
谢喽，上帝谢喽。
Here I am thinking I have nothing else in me to keep going, and you tell me the road ahead is too much for me.
就在我以为我都已经跑不了的时候，然后你现在告诉我前面还有很远的路要跑。
Thank you. I feel so refreshed right now.
我现在真的是觉得好有力气。
I feel so happy, so blessed, so blessed.
听你这样讲完，我们真的是哈哈哈。
God is good all the time, God.
是哈哈哈，你真的是良善，哈哈哈哈。
God, you're good.
太棒了
The road ahead is too much for me.
你现在告诉我前面还有很远的路要跑。
And I can do this.
然后说可以做到。
But remember, I said.
但你记得我说过。
Disappointment changes the way you look at things.
当你失望的时候，可能你看事情的眼光都不一样。
The hope also changes the way you look at things.
但同样的，当你有盼望的时候，你看事情的眼光也会很不一样。
So you can look at that statement.
所以同样的一句话。
The road ahead is too much for you.
你可以说前面还有很远的路要走。
You can look at that and say that's hard. I can't do this.
你可以想说好远哦，我走不了。
And sometimes in our disappointment, that's what we see.
有的时候，当你失望的时候，你只会看到你走不
了。When you've experienced a pain and hurt, and you try your best and still didn't work, that's what you see.
因为你一想到那些痛苦也好，那些难过，你想要摆脱的事情都已经尽力还摆脱不了，所以你一看到你只觉得失望啊。
But hope gives you a different perspective.
可是当你有盼望的时候，你的眼光完全不一样。
So you can also look at that statement.
同样的一句话。
The road ahead.
他讲的是你前面还有很远的路。
Can I just tell you something?
我可不可以告诉你
？You still have days, and not just days, your best days ahead of you.
你前面还有很远的路，而且我告诉你，那不是随随便便一条路，是那一条最好的路在等着你。
You are not like your ancestors.
你跟你的祖先不会像他们一样。
You have no more days ahead of you.
你不会像他们一样，前面已经没得活了。
You still have days ahead of you.
我告诉你，最美好的日子还在等着你呢。
There is still more blessing to come.
更要更大的祝福要来到。
There is more strength.
更好更远的力气
The best days of your life are still ahead of you.
更大的力量还在你的前头
More hope, more love, more friendships ahead of you than behind you.
有更大的盼望，有更多的朋友，更美好的未来在等着你
Now it's not going to be easy.
但我告诉你，这条路也不容易
And don't trust anybody who tells you it's going to be easy.
如果有人告诉你说，哦，前面的路很好走，你不要随便听
It's not going to be easy.
不会很好走的。
But you got this.
可是你可以走得完。
Because God's got you.
因为神会跟你一起。
God says to Elijah.
神对以利亚说。
The days ahead, they still have a lot of days ahead of you, a lot of road ahead of you.
我告诉你，前面的日子还很长呢，因为你还有很远的路要走。所以你赶快起来。
And eat.
赶快吃饱了。
Listen, God's not going to take away the fight.
神不会让你不去面对那些征战
But he will feed you.
可是他会喂饱你，让你好上战场
He will feed you.
他会喂饱你
Because God is the God who lay a table before you in front of your enemies.
因为神是会在我们敌人面前为我们摆设筵席的神
Because he knows you gotta be well fed to face what you need to face.
因为他知道你要吃饱了，才有力气去面对那些你要面对的战
You still have battles ahead of you.
那些仗还在前面等着你。
You still have fight ahead of you.
那些仗还在前面等着你去打。
But I just want to remind you.
可是我只是要提醒你。
If there are still battles,
如果前面还有仗要打
，That means there are still victories for you to experience.
那就表示我们有更多的得胜。
Your best testimonies is not in the past.
我告诉你，你那些你以为你最好的见证，你都做完了。
Your best testimonies are still ahead of you.
前面你还有更大的见证要为主来做。
So God fed this guy Elijah, and then he went for 40 days.
所以在这里，神让以利亚他吃饱了以后，接着他走了四十昼夜。
40 days to go where?
四十昼夜去到哪
？To this mountain called Mount Horeb.
去到这座何烈山。
Horeb.
何烈山。
What does that mean?
何烈山是什么意思
？Horeb is called the mountain of God.
何烈山，我们刚读到它是上帝的山。
Which is interesting because if you know what it means,
讲到上帝的山，你听觉得哇很棒。可是如果你知道何烈是什么意思的话
，because Horeb actually means wasteland,
就很有趣，因为何烈的意思其实是荒地
，or dried up,
或者是干枯
，wasteland or dried up,
枯干的荒地。
What a horrible name!
这个名字那也叫你恐怖。
Mount Horeb,
何烈山。
It's also called the mountain of the Lord.
它却也是上帝的山。
Now, why is the mountain of God called a wasteland?
那为什么就是上帝的山居然是荒地山呢？
Because it is at the place that we feel the most dried up.
我告诉你，因为就是在你最干枯的时候。
It's the place of your greatest defeats.
也就是在你觉得你好像最失败的时候。
It's the place of the greatest wasteland in your life.
好像在你生命里面最大的那片荒地。
Where you feel the most hopeless.
你觉得在那里一点盼望都没有。
The place where you feel like you have no more future.
你一看到你就觉得哪有什么未来可言。
That God does His greatest work.
但神就是要在那个地方来做成那最奇妙的工作。
So we know in the story in the Old Testament, there's a place called desolate, a place called wasteland, but it's also called the mountain of God.
所以在旧约里面，我们知道有这个既是荒地也是干枯的地方，可是它同时也是上帝的山。
What about the New Testament?
那新约呢
？Now there is a mountain in the New Testament.
新约里面有一座山
，where God also made an appearance.
神也同样在那里做类似这样的事。
And also has a pretty horrible name.
神在那里出现，然后同样在那里发生可怕的事。
No,
那名也是有可怕的名字，也很可怕。
The name of the mountain is called Golgotha.
那个名字叫做骷髅地。
Or Calvary.
或者是哥哥他。
It was this mountain.
这座山。
where thousands of people had their lives ended.
有许多成千上万的人的生命就是葬送在那里。
It's called Golgotha because that's where people would be brought to be crucified and die and never to be raised again.
它之所以叫枯骨地，是因为有很多人就是被带到那里去钉十字架，
然后自此不复生。It was on those mountains.
就是在那座山。
That thousands of lives, thousands of dreams came to an end.
许多的梦想就是葬送在那里了。
And John chapter 19.
第十九，约翰福音第十九章。
It says, finally, Pilate he handed him over Jesus to be crucified. So the soldiers who took charge of Jesus, carrying his cross, he went out to the place of the skull, which in Aramaic is called Golgotha.
于是比拉多将耶稣交给他们去钉十架，他们就把耶稣带走了。耶稣背着自己的十架出来，前往骷髅地，那地方希伯来话叫哥哥他。
Golgotha is the place where many lives came to an end.
在这个骷髅地或是哥哥他，很多生命就是葬送在这里。
But then Jesus came to the mountain.
当耶稣被带到这座山上
，and he put his cross on the mountain.
他把自己的十架好像立在那里。
And he declared his sovereignty over the mountain.
他宣告我在这里也统治了这座山，治理了这座山。
And he died on that mountain.
他就在那座山上献上
他的生命。And Golgotha, from that moment on,
从那个时候起
is no longer called the place of death.
那个骷髅地就不再叫做死亡之地。
But from that moment on,
从他死去那一刻
，Golgotha,
这个地方
or Calvary,
哥哥他或是我们说加略山
will be known as a place where humanity is reborn.
我们大家就知道那里是人类可以重生的地方。
So today we will sing about Calvary.
所以今天我们会唱加略山。
Today we will sing about Golgotha.
我们会来唱这个哥哥他或是骷髅地的歌。
Today we will sing about the cross.
当我们来唱这个十字架的时候。
Not to remind us of the shame, the mistakes of our past.
那个十字架不再是提醒我们过去的错误或是悔恨。
But the victory that God has given us.
而是看见神所赐给我们的得胜。
And the days that lay ahead.
我告诉你，在你前头的日子。
So why don't we stand up right now?
还是最美好的日子，我们大家从座位上面站立起来。
I want to pray for you.
我们要起来为你祷告。
The cross is where God does His greatest work.
十字架总是神他做成他最大工作的地方。
And today,
今天
there are many of us
我们当中有很多人
who feel like
你感觉
you're in a place of death, a place of disappointment, a place where you don't know how to keep going.
你觉得自己好像就是在那个死地，好像已经没有任何盼望，非常的干枯，你不知道自己要怎么走下去。
Today, as we worship,
今天当我们在敬拜的时候。
A new strength is going to come in.
我要祷告有个新的力量进到你里面。
Power is going to come in.
有个新的能力要进到你里面。
His life is going to come in.
他的生命要进到你里面。
So I pray right now in the name of Jesus.
我现在要奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
Why don't you lift up your hands?
我们高举起我们的手。
Right now in the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Right now in the name of Jesus.
奉耶稣基督的名。
Every single person here.
每一个人就在我们现场每一个人，或是在线上的每一个人。
You have the hands lifted up.
你若是举起你的手，抓就是现在。
Your power.
我要祷告的能力。你的生命。
Will come in.
要进到他们的生命里。
There are many of us.
我们当中有很多人。
Who are at our Mount Horeb right now?
你可能觉得自己好像是在何烈山上。
Who are standing on Golgotha right now?
你可能觉得你好像在那个干枯的骷髅地上。
On Golgotha.
在这个哥哥他上。
Does not just lay thousands of bodies, but on Golgotha lay stand the cross of Jesus Christ.
在骷髅地不是有过去那成千上万的人好像死在那里，在那里有主耶稣他的十字架。
Today.As we worship,
就是今天当我们敬拜的时候，我们宣告
the power of the cross,
十字架的大能力大在我们的生命里面。
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for the power of the blood. It's so powerful, powerful.
Right now, I ask everybody here today
to
just close your eyes just for a moment.
不论是线上或是线上，我们邀请闭上眼睛。
And here's this question.
我要问你。
That I've been waiting to ask you.
我一直忍不住要问你这个问题。
Is there anybody here today?
我要我们当中有没有人
？Who have not given their life to Jesus?
你还没有把自己的生命交给耶稣过。
You never said, Jesus, I invite you into my life.
你从来没有说过耶稣，我邀请你进到我的生命。
To be my Lord and my Savior.
我的生命的主和我的救主。
Maybe you heard the gospel before. You heard Bible stories before.
可能你听过福音，你也听过很多圣经故事。
And you heard preachings before.
你也听过人家讲道。
But your life is not changed by what you heard. Your life is changed.By your response.
可是你要知道，你的生命不会因为你听到了什么而有所改变，而是要看你愿意做出什么样的行动来有所改变。
And today is an opportunity for you to respond to what God is asking you.
今天就看你是可以来做出这个回应。听到神对你说话的时候，你可以来做出回应的时候。
And many of you today, you're living in darkness.
可是你觉得自己好像活在一个黑暗的里面。
And I don't blame you.
我不怪你。
Because you don't know any other way.
因为那也是你唯一知道的方式。
But what if I tell you today?
可是如果今天我告诉你
that you have a God who loves you.
有一位神，他非常的爱你。
He sent His Son, Jesus Christ.
爱你到一个地步，他差派自己的爱子耶稣。
To die for you on the cross.
为你来死在十字架上。
For your sins.
是为你的罪。
To wash away your shame.
好叫你的羞愧可以被洗净。
And to cleanse you of all unrighteousness.
然后洗净你一切的罪，让你成为公义。
And today,
今天
you can receive Him.
你可以来接受他。
And be made new.
然后成为一个全新的人。
In Jesus Christ.
在耶稣基督里。
What if I tell you that?
如果我告诉你这是有可能的。
How would you respond to that?
那你会怎么来回应呢？
And I pray and I hope that you will make the decision to give your life to Him completely. So, eyes closed, heads bowed.
所以我们每一个人，不论你在现场、线上，你可以把眼睛闭着，然后头低下来。
Especially for those who are watching online right now.
特别是在网络上面观看的弟兄姐妹。
I want to lead you in a word of prayer.
在网络上面观看的人，我要带你来做这个祷告。
When I count to three,
等我数到三
I will ask you,
我要问你
if you want to pray this with me.
如果你愿意跟我一起做这个祷告
if you want to receive Jesus,
如果你想要接受耶稣
if you want Him to help you,
如果你希望他来帮助你
to put up your hand.
如果你愿意等一下数到三你就举起你的手
One,
一
Two,
二
You ready?
你预备好了吗
Three, put up your hand.
如果你愿意的话可以举起你的手
I see you,
我看到了举起手如果你愿意的话可以把手举起来我看到了
I see you, I see you, I see you.I see you.
我看到了，我看到了，我看到了，我看到了，我看到了，我看到了。
I see you. I see you. That's including you watching online. Put up your hand too.
包含在网络上面观看，如果你愿意的话，你也可以举起手。
Okay. Now put your hand on your heart.
你可以把手放在你的心上。
I'm going to pray for you.
我要来为你祷告。
I'm going to pray for you.
我们要来为你祷告。
In fact, I'm going to lead you to pray with me.
等一下，应该是说我带你跟我一起来做这个祷告。
So as I pray, I just pray that.I ask that you will repeat after me, and everybody, we're going to do it together.
所以呢，等一下我祷告一句，你跟我祷告一句，我们现场所有人会跟你一起来做这个祷告。
Because we're a family.
因为我们是一家人，所以我们一起祷告。
So want to pray with you.
想要跟你一起来祷告。
Say, dear Heavenly Father.
你跟我一起说，亲爱的天父。
I come before you.
我来到你面前。
I thank you.
我感谢你。
For your Son.
你的爱子。
Jesus Christ.
耶稣基督。
Who went to the cross?
为我上十架
To die for my sins.
为我的罪死
Today,
今天
I open my heart.
我打开我的心
To receive Him.
来接受他
As my Lord.
成为我生命的主
And my Savior.
和我的救主
And I thank you, Jesus.
耶稣，我感谢你
That you rose from the dead.
你从死里复活
To give me a new life.
好叫我有全新的生命
So today,
今天
Because of you,
因着你
my life,
我的生命
is not the same.
将不再一样。
My life,
我的生命
is filled with hope,
是充满盼望。
And I have the strength,
我有力量
for the days ahead.
可以再走下去。
In Jesus' name, I pray.
奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
In Jesus' name, I pray.
奉耶稣基督的名求。
In Jesus' name, I pray.
奉耶稣基督的名求。
And all God's people said,
神的百姓，我们都说
，Amen,
Amen,
Amen.
亲爱的朋友，希望今天的讲道对你来说有很大的帮助。但是不要停在这里，可以把这个影片分享给你觉得有需要的亲朋好友。你也可以订阅这个频道，你就不会 miss 掉任何最新的影片。再来，每个礼拜天都可以邀请你加入在我们 Hope Nation 的一份子，一起在线上加入我们的线上组织。最重要的是，如果今天这个讲道对你有帮助的话，我想邀请你成我们的一份子，透过奉献，可以点选奉献这个钮，加入在我们的 Hope 的大家庭，这样子可以帮助我们把这样的影片、这样的讲道传给更多有需要的人。谢谢你慷慨的给予。